Hi guys, welcome to Instant Film. Today, we will be recapping a hostage thriller from 2002 called Panic Room. It's a suspense-filled movie that has a thrilling climax, so stay till the end to experience it all. Let's begin. Lydia Lynch finally manages to find a house that might potentially be liked by Meg Altman, a divorced lady. So, she leads Meg to the house. Meg's daughter Sarah Altman also goes with her to check the house out. Sarah has a very stern attitude. Evan shows them the magnificent house. It's incredibly large with a garden, an elevator, three floors and a mysterious room called the panic room attached to the master bedroom. The panic room is to keep the residents of the house safe in case of an invasion. It has all the requirements necessary to sustain life. The panic room is virtually unbreakable with strong steel surrounding it. It also has CCTVs for surveillance. Meg has conflicting feelings about the room, but that doesn't stop them from buying the house. Meg's ex-husband, Stephen Altman, pays the cost and Meg with Sarah starts living there. Meg and Sarah share some heartfelt moments with each other. After Sarah sleeps, Meg consumes alcohol like an addict. She does so due to the grief caused by her husband who cheated on her. She sobers up a little and starts experimenting with the controls of the panic room. One of her cliques turns on the CCTVs. She doesn't pay heed to it and goes to sleep. It is followed by a brilliant one-take sequence of two thieves trying to get in. First thief tries getting in through all the doors but fails. He finally finds a hatch that he manages to open and gets in. His name is Burnham. He is shocked on seeing Meg and Sarah in there. He lets the other thief in, who's called Junior. Junior brings with him an unexpected third person, Raul, but Burnham isn't very happy about it. When they plan to come in, they didn't expect anyone to be in the house, so they panic for a while. Burnham is even about to leave, but Junior assures him that Raul can handle the family and reminds him about the $3 million in the house. Plus, Raul has a gun. Meg is up and walks around the bedroom but doesn't notice the CCTV. Burnham joins back and they tiptoe their way to the top floor. Meg flushes the toilet and returns to her bed. Panic room's light is on, so she goes to turn it off. It's then that she sees the three thieves on the CCTV. She runs to Sarah's room. The thieves see her running and follow her. She wakes up Sarah and hurries her to the stairs but finds Raul on the way. She sidetracks him and gets into the elevator. They press the ground floor button. Junior tries to open the elevator at the first floor but it doesn't open. He heads to the ground floor. Meg remembers the panic room and head to the respective floor with some help from Sarah. They exit the elevator and rush to the master bedroom. Junior and Raul follow them. Meg and Sarah manage to get into the panic room. Junior smashes the mirror in utter anger. Meg tries to comfort Sarah but she acts very self-sufficient. Meg tries using phone but it doesn't work because the lines aren't connected. The thieves are figuring out what to do because the money is in the panic room. Meg finds a PA system which works like a microphone. She uses it to communicate with the thieves and claims that the police is coming, to make them fear. Burnham can't talk back, so he uses sign language to let her know that they know the phones are not working. They try communicating to her that she should come out of the room if she wants them to leave. They'll leave once they rob the room. Meg shuts them up by telling them to get out. Left with no choice, Burnham takes out all his tools and they close all the doors from inside, leaving no way for Meg and Sarah to get out. Meg sees this and fears. Sarah tries to find something of use in the room. They are interrupted by a sound from underneath. Raul tries to break in the panic room through below it. Burnham calls this effort useless and looks around for something else. He finds a container with harmful gas in it. He takes it up with him and the other follows. He makes a hole in the vent of the room and connects a pipe from the container to the hole. He issues a warning to Meg by leaking the gas into the room but doesn't want them to be harmed. Meg and Sarah see all these activities and notice the gas coming in. Sarah finds a hole through which she gets fresh air. Meg tries tapping the duct to prevent the poisonous gas from coming in. Raul increases the gas going in, so Burnham argues with him to turn the gas down. Meg finds an igniter in the room. She covers herself and Sarah with a fireproof cloth and starts lighting the igniter. The thieves listen to the sound of igniter but don't figure out what it is. Burnham backs off when he gets the idea. Meg keeps trying to turn it on and finally does. It causes a huge fire that puts Junior's arm on fire. Meg gets down and covers both herself and her daughter. Junior curses back at Meg. Sarah picks up a torch and uses it through the hole she had discovered to wake up the neighbor. The neighbor wakes up but only to shut down his curtains. Meg and Sarah are disappointed. The thieves get out of the room and are distracted by arguments among themselves. Meg sees this and makes use of the chance. She runs outside to get her cell phone. When she doesn't find it at its place, she looks under the bed and there it is. Thieves are arguing all this while. She reaches out to it and in the process, the lamp falls, alerting the thieves. They rush back into the room. Meg gets hold of the phone and rushes back to the panic room. Burnham just enters the room and misses Meg by a slight distance. She is back in the panic room. The cell phone has no network in there, so she tries connecting the landline to the wire that still has connectivity. Burnham runs to the ground floor. The police don't answer, so Meg calls her ex-husband. She tells him about the thieves but is cut off in the middle by Burnham. Now, she expects that her husband will call the police. Sarah is feeling dizzy and hungry as her sugar level has gone low. She is diabetic. Meg gives her milk to drink. Outside, Junior gives up and goes downstairs. Burnham follows him as he reveals that there's much more money in the safe than he mentioned. Junior gets to the gate and is about to leave when Raul shoots at him, blowing his brains out. Sarah gets to see this and her sugar level is affected by it. Meg consoles her. A person appears at the gate, it's Steven Altman. Raul grabs him and kicks him down. Burnham tries to escape, but Raul prevents him. He forces Burnham to come up with an idea. They show the ID of Steven to Meg, and then Raul starts torturing Steven to compel Meg out of the room. Meg grieves but doesn't leave the room. Sarah's sugar level has gone seriously low and Meg lays her down. Raul is beating up Steven. Burnham tries stopping him and finally does him unconscious. He carries him through the stairs and to the ground floor. Meg uses the moment and gets out to find Steven laying on the bed face down. She calls him, but when he doesn't wake, she heads to the upper floor. It's then revealed that the person isn't Steven, it's Raul. And the person on ground is Steven. Meg gets Sarah's injection and heads back to the room. She sees the thieves standing there and is alerted. Raul notices Meg's presence and waits for her beside a door. Burnham is inside the room preparing for the robbery. Meg pushes her way into the bedroom, pushing Raul to fall. She stops seeing Burnham. Raul grabs her from behind, but she pulls his jacket, throwing him inside the room. She falls but manages to throw the injection kit inside the panic room as Burnham closes the door. Raul's fingers get squashed with the door in the process. Raul and Burnham are locked inside the room with Sarah. Meg is outside and desperately bangs on the door. Raul's hand is still stuck between the door. He pleads Burnham to open the door, but Burnham doesn't do it because he doesn't want Meg to get in. She picks up Raul's gun and points it at the camera. Using a communicator beside the bed, she tells Burnham to let her give Sarah injection, but Burnham replies that he can't let her in. She tells him to give the injection himself. Burnham agrees but asks Meg to leave the room and go to the ground floor. Meg does as he said. Burnham opens the door and lets Raul have his hand. Meg runs back in to get to the room, but Burnham closes the door just before she could get in. Sarah's condition is worsening, so Burnham gives her the injection, proving his humanity. Meg gets down to Steven and a doorbell rings. The police has arrived. Steven tells her that he had called the police. Raul sees this and looks at Sarah with an intention to kill her, but Burnham thinks otherwise and correctly guesses that the police was called by Steven. Fearing that the thieves might kill Sarah, Meg says that she will handle the police. She talks to the police and tells them that there is no problem. But one of the policemen doesn't believe her. He tries to comfort Meg and asks her to tell the truth. Meg repeats that there's no problem and insists them to go. The policemen leave, but with a hint of doubt in them. Burnham uncovers the locker and starts drilling it. He stops only when Raul shouts at Meg, who is breaking down all the cameras. Burnham doesn't let this distract him and continues his work. Sarah manages to get all the injections from the kit into her hand. Meg prepares herself for the thieves' arrival. The lock has opened and Burnham takes out the bank bonds from it. He calculates the total worth of those bonds, it is $22 million. Meg tapes a gun to Steven's broken hand and places a lamp on him. Burnham leaves the tools and gets out of the panic room with Raul and Sarah. He finds all the doors of the master bedroom locked except one, through which he exits the room and heads downstairs. Meg turns elevator's light off. She observes the thieves and Sarah as they pass in front of her. The thieves get to the ground floor and a lamp's light shines at them, it's Steven. He has the gun and demands Burnham to leave the girl. Meg sneaks from behind with a hammer and smashes it on Raul's head. Sarah gets back with Meg. Burnham escapes the house by breaking through a glass wall. He is in the yard and tries to get over the brick wall. Raul gets back on his feet and chases Meg. Steven shoots at him but misses. Raul hits Steven back, which causes the gun to fall. Raul picks up the hammer and with its help, crawls towards Meg. He grabs Meg and climbs on her. Sarah uses the injection she has to distract Raul, but he punches her back and she falls. He picks up the hammer and is about to hit Meg. A hand picks up the gun, it's Burnham. He shoots Raul and saves Meg. The sirens are louder than ever now. Burnham gets out of the house and is in the yard. The police come in the house and spread out. Burnham is about to climb the wall, but the police catch him and he lifts his hands up. All the bond papers fly off. Meg and Sarah finally take a sigh of relief. Next day, Sarah is going through the newspaper scouting for houses and telling her mother about it. Meg reminds Sarah to look only for small houses that are appropriate for them. Panic Room is a thrilling entry from the maestro David Fincher. One of the best things about the movie are the villains and the conflicting personalities that each of them possesses. There are much more such qualities about this movie that make it such a fun watch. Let me know of some of those qualities that you noticed in the comments. Also, watch the whole movie once to experience the thrills in their full sense. Thanks for watching and subscribe to Instant Film for more such great recaps.